Aloha, my name is Ashly Gutierrez. I like to say that I'm speaking on behalf of all the people that, you know, graduated from here within the past 5 years. And I'm glad to say that I'm finally waking up to realize what's going on. I have few important questions that I like to be addressed. First of all, I lived in Wanagoa Valley for 5 years. After, on my 6th birthday, my father died of cancer. What a surprise. Allison spoke about that, and that got to me. If that doesn't get 20 of you here, I understand why you guys haven't acted quickly. Because you don't understand. It's not only the money that you play with here, but the children, their future. And I'm standing here 22 years later, and I've lived in the mainland, cursed this state, but I'm back and I'm not leaving. And I want to make sure that the Navy understands that, the military understands that. We're here. We've been here. Where have you guys come from? Why would this even bother you? It bothers us most. And the other lady clearly made a statement. They did not once consult the people that live there. How will they compensate those who are affected by this bill? Can we have a copy of the risk management and safety policy published for review by the community? They say Navy cannot fix for a minimum of 2 years. Remember, I'm 22 years old. My father died when I was 6 years old of cancer. What is, you know, the evidence is all laid out right in front of our eyes. Do they have other tanks that have potential leaks on our other islands? Is there any way they can possibly operate the tanks on ships or other places? And don't you guys think that you should figure out the flow pattern before you even decide to dig up the aina? That's all I have to say. Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.